but I'm in a tree museum.
Hey y'all, so I'm back again with another video. This time it's a little bit different from my last one. This one is aiming to be a little bit more informative than my previous how-to video. I really want to talk about some African Americans who have been leaders and trailblazers, no pun intended, maybe a little, when it comes to bridging the gap between African Americans and the outdoors. This is more specifically known as the adventure gap. And in light of the video that went viral in which a white woman called the police on a black man who was bird watching, y'all know the one.
Please call the cops. Please call the cops.
I'm gonna tell them there's an African American man threatening my life.
Need I say more? So what is the adventure gap? The adventure gap is a term coined by journalist James Edward Mills, who is also author of The Adventure Gap, to basically describe the lack of diversity in outdoor recreation and outdoor adventure sports. Hearing James Mills talk back in my sophomore year when I was in undergrad is really what got me interested in this topic to begin with back in like 2016, 2017, and to this day, I still think we should be having this conversation. And although there have been various black people in the US who have gone on to create organizations and educational platforms dedicated to address this issue, we need more knowledge, more eyes, and more action on this problem in general.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you either. I'm being threatened by a man in the ramble. Please send the cops immediately.
So with that, I wanted to introduce five, even though believe me, there are so much more than five, but five African American outdoor pioneers in this video to highlight the accomplishments that have gone unseen, unheard of, and have been way too overlooked by too many people in the US. So let's get started. Number one, Matthew Henson. Matthew Henson was an early 20th century adventurer who was a critical member of US Navy Captain Robert Peary's expedition team to the North Pole. Before this expedition, Henson had been accompanying Peary on 6 voyages into the Arctic over the next 20 years, where he mastered the Inuit language and became known as the only non-Inuit to become skilled in driving dog sleds and training dog teams traditionally. On April 6, 1909, it was Henson driving the lead sled and whose footprints first pressed into the snow to cross latitude 90 into the North Pole. Almost 50 years later, Henson receives the recognition he deserves as a partner in that expedition in 1954 under President Eisenhower. In 2000, 45 years after his death, the National Geographic Society posthumously awards Henson the prestigious Hubbard Medal. Ironically enough, the first recipient of the medal was Robert Peary in 1906. Number 2. George W. Gibbs, Jr. Gibbs was one of 40 men selected to join polar explorer Admiral Richard E. Byrd III's U.S. Antarctic Service Expedition, and on January 14, 1940, Gibbs became the first African American to set foot on the continent of Antarctica. Gibbs would go on to continue serving in the military, earn his degree, and serve as a civil rights leader. To honor Gibbs, on September 2, 2009, 9 years after Gibbs' death, the rock point that marked the northernmost tip of Antarctica was deemed Gibbs Point. Number 3. Sophia Dannenberg. Sophia Dannenberg is an avid mountain climber who started rock climbing at first in 1999 when she was 27. In 2005, 1 year before her big feat, she scaled Mount McKinley, Rainier, and Kilimanjaro. On May 19, 2006, Dannenberg summited the world's tallest mountain above sea level. She was the first African American and the first black woman from any country to successfully reach the summit. During her Everest journey, she suffered frostbite and bronchitis. Dannenberg now lives in Seattle, putting her Harvard Environmental Science and Public Policy degrees to use, working on global chemical and environmental regulations for Boeing. Number 4, Kai Leitner. Leitner is 20 years old, only 2 years younger than me, and has already earned at least 12 national championship titles for climbing, and he's a 5-time youth world champion medalist. Leitner first started climbing at a local gym in North Carolina at 6 years old. During that same year, he already began competitive climbing. In 2014 was when he earned the gold medal for his age group at the Youth World Championship and became the first American lead world champion since 1995. And looking at his Instagram, he still continues to practice climbing and is no doubt a role model for all climbers of color. Number 5, Audrey Peterman. Peterman is the co-author of the book Legacy on the Land, which she and her husband wrote after embarking on a 12,000-mile road trip across the U.S. where they tried to visit as many national parks as possible. Not surprisingly, there was a great lack of diversity in park visitors, and that inspired their response to write a book. They also continue to speak out about preserving nature and natural parks, as well as educating others about the history of African American influence in the national park system. All great people, and honestly, again, not even close to highlighting all the people that need recognition in this area. I think there can be this stigma that the outdoors is for white people, that things like camping, kayaking, mountain climbing, etc. are for white people. And honestly, that mentality can be harmful, especially when, as a result, we have less POCs and specifically African Americans that are less invested in environmental stewardship. Especially because they are also the communities that can be the most affected by environmental injustices and need to have a say in this area. It's time we start normalizing Black explorers, conservationists, foresters, adventurers, outdoor recreationists, and the like. And one way to do this, I think, is to just start talking about African Americans in this field. If you folks are interested in learning more about this topic or more about the adventure gap in general, let me know in the comments below and I'll get started on working on more informative videos. But that's all I have for now, so until next time. Don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you got till it's gone? You'd be in paradise and put up a funky